Today we are doing cost sheet along with estimated cost sheet or quotation cost sheet. Okay, in the question you will be receiving the data for few units. By seeing that, you have to estimate for the next cost sheet. Okay, what is the total price they are supposed to give, that and all you have to show in the cost sheet. Okay, so let us see the question. Here you have three columns. Total output is 1000 units. What is the amount in rupees and what will be the price for each unit? That you have to find out through the number of units. Okay. So now first let's see the data. Is there any opening materials in the given question? Opening materials is there?
Stock of materials on January 1st, 2014, 6000 rupees.
6000 rupees is the opening stock. You can write down directly in the amount, or you can first mention everything in the inner column and then you can write down in the outer column. Okay, when first you can start with inner column only. Any purchases are there? Add purchases.
Purchase of materials in January 2014, 1,44,000.
1,44,000. So the total is 1,50,000. Is there any closing stock? If you have closing stock, you have to subtract from this. If there is no closing stock, you have to leave like this only. Is there any closing stock?
Stock of materials on 31st January 2014, 10,000.
So it is closing stock is 10,000. Now total materials consumed is 1,40,000. To manufacture 1000 units, they have utilized total 1,40,000 rupees. Okay? This is called materials consumed. Next, is there any wages?
Wages 55,000.
Wages is 55,000. Next, any direct expenses or chargeable expenses given in the question? There is no. If it is there, you have to mention that one. Direct expenses or chargeable expenses. If it is there, take that and do the total. The total is called as prime cost. Now do the total. This will be 1,95,000 is called prime cost. This is called prime cost. Okay. You can do immediately what is the cost per unit, or first complete the total cost sheet and then you can find out what is the cost per each unit. Okay. I want first let me finish it off totally and then I will move on to the cost per unit. To this, add factory overheads. Is there any factory overheads?
A factory overheads for the month 60,000.
It is 60,000. If it is split, different expenses are given. Mention that and then do the total. He gave you directly the total amount. What is the amount?
60,000.
60,000. Now do the total. You will get 2,55,000. This is called either factory cost or box cost. You can call it as box cost or factory cost. To this, add administrative overheads. What is administrative overheads?
Administrative and selling overheads per unit each rupees 25.
So for each unit they spent 25 rupees it seems. Total how many units are there? 1000 units are there. So you have to take 1000 into 25. Total 25,000 rupees. So how much you will get? 2,80,000. This is cost of production. This is called cost of production. To this, add selling and distribution overheads. Selling and distribution overheads. Selling and distribution also 25 rupees per unit. So 1000 into 25, you are getting 25,000. Then the total is 3,05,000. This is called total cost. Is there any profit or sales given in the question?
Selling price per unit 320. 20.
So total you have selling price. There is no profit. If you add profit to this, then you will get sales or selling price. What is the sales mentioned in the question? 320.
320.
Total how many units are there? 1000 units are there. 1000 1000 into 320, you will get 3,20,000. Now, what is the difference? Total cost is 3,05,000 and sales is 3,20,000. The profit will be the balancing figure, that is 15,000. Got it? Now, how to find out cost per unit? Cost per unit, for each one, you have to find out what is the total material consumed, 1,40,000. Total number of units are 1,000. So, each unit cost is 1,40,000 divided by 1,000. 1,40,000 divided by 1,000, you will get 140. So, here cost per unit is 140. Wages, 55,000. So, 55,000 divided by 1,000, you will get 55. This is nil. Then you will get the total of 195, or if you have doubt, 1,95,000 divided by 1,000 units you can do. Now here 60,000 divided by 1,000 units, you will get 60. Then the total 255. Now here 25,000, already in the question itself they have given you, it is 25 rupees per unit. Now the total 280, and again this is 25 only, 3,05,000. Now this one, 3,05,000 divided by 1,000 units, you will get 305. So this is 305. Next, 15,000 divided by 1,000, you will get 15 rupees. 15. Now the total is 320, already given in the question, or if you want to find out, 320,000 divided by 1,000 units, you will get 320. This is the normal cost sheet. Now, by taking these amounts or cost per units under consideration, you have to prepare quotation cost sheet. Thank you. Yeah, now we started quotation cost sheet. Okay, let's see the given data. Last normal cost sheet for 1000 units, here you are estimating for 2000 units with few changes. What are those changes? Let us see. Materials consumed has increased by 20%, wages has decreased by 10%, factory overheads increased by 5%, administrative selling and distribution overheads decreased by 20%. That is the given data. By taking under consideration of all these details, you have to find out for 2000 units. Okay, so now let's start with the materials consumed. Materials consumed is actual, when you calculated in the cost sheet, you got cost per unit is 140. It should be increased by 20%. That means 140 plus 140 into 20 by 100. Then you will get 28 rupees. So 140 plus 28, 168 into, total how many units you have? 2000 units. Once again, 140 into 20 by 100, you will be getting 28 rupees has increased. 140 plus 28, you are getting total 168 for how many units? 2000 units. How much you will get? 168 into 2000? 168 into 2000?
$3,36,000.
Now, wages has decreased by 10%. Actual price is 55 and it is decreased by 5%. So, let us find out how much you will get. 55 into 10%. You are getting 5 rupees. So, it has decreased by 5%. 10% means minus 5. How much you will get? Not 5. 5.5 you will get. It is 5.5. What is the answer? 49.5 into 2000. 49.5 into 2000.
99,000.
You will get 99,000. What is the total? 99,000 divided by 2000. You will be getting again 49.5. If you want, you can cross check. 99,000 divided by 2000. If you cross check, you will get 49.5. Now, what is the total of this? $4,35,000 prime cost. Next, factory overheads are increased by 5%. 5%. So let us see what is the 5%. 60 into 5 by 100, you will be getting 3 rupees. It is increased. So it will be 60 plus 3. So 2000 into 63. How much you will get? 2000 into 63?
1,26,000.
1,26,000. Then what is the total? 1,26,000 plus 4,35,000.
Five lakh sixty one thousand.
Now what is this total? 280.5. Works cost is 280.5 cost per unit, and the total amount is 5,61,000. Now administrative overheads decreased by 20%. So how much you will get? 25 into 20 by 100, you will be getting 5 rupees. It is decreased. So you will be taking 25 minus 5. Then the answer is 20 into 2000 units, you will get 40,000. Then here the amount is 200. What is the total? 6,01,000, and this is 300.5. This is cost of production. Next, selling and distribution overheads. This also decreased by 20%. Again, on 25, 20% is rupees 5. So now you will get 25 minus 5. So how many units? 2000 units into 20 rupees. How much you will get? 40,000. And then this will be 20. Now the total is 6,41,000. And this is 320.5. This is called total cost. And next, there is no change in the profit. Last one, how much profit you got? The same percentage of profit you are gonna get. So first find out what is the profit percentage. To find out profit percentage, profit divided by total cost into 100. If you are calculating on the sales, then you will get profit divided by sales into 100. I am calculating on the total cost. So in the last question, you got 15,000 divided by 3,05,000, you got 4.92. I made it wrong figure. I got 5%. Now here, what is the total cost? 6,41,000 on that 5%. Add profit. 6,41,000 into 5 by 100. How much you will get? 6,41,000 into 5%.
32,050
divided by 2000.
16.025.
So I call it 16. Now do the total, you will get the total selling price is 336.5 per unit. The total amount will be, sales amount will be 6,73,050 rupees. If you increase from 1000 units to 2000 units with few changes, always, sometimes, every time it will not be same, you will be having the same type of prices. Sometimes prices may increase, prices may decrease. Now here some of them have increased and some of them have decreased. So with that, if you calculate for 2000 units, you got cost per unit 336.5 and the total amount is 6,73,050. Okay, hope all of you understood. Thank you.